What's good, beautiful people? So let's get started. I'm using this dome cap that I got from a beauty supply store for only 15 rand, and I'm just gonna place it over my mannequin head. Next up, I'm going to be taking these curly bundles that I also got from a beauty supply store for 120 rand. Honestly, I ended up straightening the bundles because I wasn't happy with the quality at the end. So I'm also going to be going in with my hooked shaped needle, and I'm just going to be sewing down the track on the nape of my neck. This is to make sure that there aren't any sparse areas once I am finished with the wig. Once I have sewed down from one end to the next, I'm going to fold over the bundles. I'm not sewing down from ear to ear, just because I just want to make sure that there is enough hair by the nape of my neck. You can use hairpins or T-pins or sewing pins to help you place down your tracks so that you don't go a little bit too astray when it comes to the lines that you want to create. So I just want to let you guys know that I am single wefting. That means the tracks are not doubled, and this is because I thought I wouldn't have enough hair for the whole wig. So I do have 6 bundles, 226 inches, 224 inches, and 222 inches. I'm going to place the longest one at the back and then continue all the way to the front with the shorter ones. Another thing you must be careful of is that when you're placing your tracks on the band, you're not picking up the elastic band, else your dome cap will become too small for you, and the elastic band is to just help you adjust the size of the dome cap. I forgot to mention that I am using thread for this wig. I am going to be doubling the thread as well. I didn't want to use wool because wool would have been too thick for the type of bundles that I was using. Typically, I would go in with the wool because it's much stronger and it will help you lay your wig down faster. But thread also will do. You just have to be careful with the tangles and everything that it comes with. Please, please, please try and ignore my attempt of trying to detangle the wig while I was sewing it. It really didn't help at the end. The hair was just messed up. The quality just went south. I really wonder what happened with this wig. But don't you worry, I will have a video of me straightening the wig coming up right after this upload. So make sure that your post notifications are on so you can receive a notification when I do upload that video. I then went off camera and sewed down the rest of the tracks following the guidelines that are already on the dome cap. That means I followed the lines that were already on the dome cap. And once I got to the top, I just came back on camera to show you guys what I am doing next. Right now, this is the crown of my wig, and I'm just going to be sewing down the tracks from side to side, making sure that when I fold it over, it's flat. You don't want to make this mistake, otherwise it will look bumpy and it will look like a helmet head, and that's one thing we don't want. So you want to make sure that the bundles are flat. You can cut bundles, but I'm not really a fan of this because your hair will shed a lot and I just don't want to cut my bundles. So you just want to make sure that you fold it over and you try and make it lay flat. You can use pins to help you direct you on which direction you want to go to so that it's way much easier for you. To be honest with you guys, I didn't make this wig all in one day. I was just doing it whenever I felt bored. So it did take me 3 days to make it, but I could have done it in one day, to be quite honest. I don't know why I was being lazy, but at the end of the day, it was done. So that's all that matters. Once I am satisfied with the space that I left for my lace, I'm going to trim my lace and match it to the size of the space. I got this lace for 13 rand per meter from my fabric store, and I got 2 meters, which was 26 rand, and girl, it's been there for almost a year and a half right now, so you really don't need 2 meters. 1 meter would do, depending on how many wigs you want to make. All the wigs that I have, I've used this lace, and honey, it's still there. And you want to make sure that you are doubling the lace, because this lace isn't the strongest lace and I wouldn't really recommend this lace. So that's why I doubled it, because from past experiences, the lace will tear if it's singled and whatever, and we just don't want that. We don't want holes in our laces, honey, nah. When it comes to sewing down the lace, you want to make sure that the thread is as flat as possible, because we don't want thread sticking out, and we also don't want the lace lifting. That's one thing we definitely do not want. And you want to cut away the excess lace. If you have like lace that is more than 3 centimeters, please try and keep it, because sometimes you might need to make a closure that's only about 3 centimeters. So now I'm going to place the wig on my head, and then I'm going to measure my center part. I know I didn't wear this wig as a middle parting, but this is to just make sure that I get the perfect center and everything is in the middle, everything is even on both sides. So now to make my closure, I'm going to take a bundle and then cut it at the weft, at the part where it's connected, and then I'm going to take my crochet that I got from a beauty supply store for 14 rand, and then I'm just going to crochet it and make sure that I am only looping through one strand of the hair. There are so many videos on YouTube about this. I will link a few in the description box down below so you can be able to check them out and understand how to make the invisible parting a little bit more. If you guys would like a detailed tutorial from me, do tell me in the comment section down below. I'll be more than happy to do that. So you just want to make sure that you are trying to place the hair in a straight line, not really close to the marking that you have. You can always go back in, and you also want to make sure that you're not taking too much hair, and you want to pull that hair through so that it's tight and it won't move anything funny like that. Whenever I start working on my closures, I always like to work from my marking. This is to just make sure that if it happens that I run out of hair, I can still wear my wig. I can still cover it up and it will look like nothing is going on. You can always finesse it with some mousse, some hairpins, even a hair tie or an Alice band or a headband. It will always work in your favor. And you also want to make sure that you're not making it to be too thick. You want it to be gradient, and we also don't want to go back in and pluck. That will take forever. We don't want to sit here and do the wig for the whole day. No, honey. So you need to work smart and not hard. Once I am satisfied with the amount of hair that's close to my parting, I'm just going to randomly place hair there. You don't have to do it in a sequence or anything like that, unless, of course, you want to have many partings. But I just really want to place the hair there so that it doesn't look weird or anything like that, and so that I don't have any bald spots. I did go off camera and finish the rest of the lace, and this is what it's looking like. I really like the gradient effect at the parting because that's what we want. We want it to look as natural as possible. This was like 2.5 weeks later, and I had just finished straightening my wig. I absolutely love the way it turned out. I don't have any regrets or whatsoever when it comes to me straightening the wig. It's way much better this way. Right now, I am just brushing my hair and deciding what I want to do with it. And then I'm going to go ahead and add some concealer to my parting, just because I felt like it wasn't defined with the foundation that I used. And then I'm just going to use a brush just to make sure that I'm removing the concealer that's on my hair. Right after that, I'm going to go in with some curl defining mousse from Perfect Touch. Honestly, this wasn't to define any curls. It was to tame away the flyaways that I had, which were really, really annoying, and this helped a lot. And then I'm just going to style my hair the way I wanted to, and that's the end of the video.